All right, let's move on to the Peach Bowl, Tom. You got Oklahoma against LSU, and you're not going to find anybody outside the greater Norman area probably that's going to pick Oklahoma to win this one outright.
Yeah, I'm taking LSU. I think the spread is the size that it is for a reason, and this one's probably going to keep growing too. But Oklahoma's a fascinating team to me because it's clearly the team that deserved the number four spot based on what we saw happen, you know, Big 12 champion. But it's also clearly a level below the other three teams in the playoff. But at the same time, I don't think we know how good this Oklahoma team can be, because the thing that Oklahoma's been best at over the last month is letting the other team stay in the game. We've seen this as an Oklahoma team that has really outplayed its opponents in this last five games, yet it keeps turning the ball over and letting these teams stick around and make it close games. This is, if we look at the Big 12 championship game on Saturday, Baylor's quarterbacks completed a third of their passes. Baylor's running backs averaged fewer than 2 yards per carry. Yet the game still had to go to overtime for Oklahoma to finally finish it. So in a way, they've been their own worst enemy, and you cannot make those kind of mistakes against this LSU team, because while the LSU defense is not the elite unit that we see with Clemson or the elite unit we see with Ohio State, it's still a very good defense with very talented players in the secondary and talented players in the front seven. And it's an offense that nobody has proven to really be able to stop consistently this season. So Oklahoma's got a very steep uphill climb, but at the same time, if they get their act together in the time that they have between now and this game, and if Jalen Hurts can start taking care of the football, this is an Oklahoma team that can win the game. I don't think it will, but I think it has a better shot than most of us are probably going to give it credit for.
Jalen Hurts has a turnover problem that Tom mentioned. It continued at Oklahoma. It started at Alabama when I was told back in the day when Tua took over the job that at that point if he didn't, there was going to be, you know, an uprising, because he would go into games. He'd been coached out of turning the ball over so much that he was afraid to let go of it. Mm-hmm. You know, he would short arm the ball, he would run the ball. And he's doing everything at Oklahoma. He just has a turnover problem, particularly in the red zone, particularly from the 50 on in. If he eliminates that in this game, they'll be fine. But I wouldn't say he's a one-man team. CeeDee Lamb might be the best receiver in these four. But when your quarterback runs for 1,200 yards and leads the conference in rushing, that's Jack Mildren stuff from the Wishbone days. And they are better defensively. But it has to start with Jalen Hurts cleaning up his game, because if he doesn't, that 11.5 is going to look like 15.
Yeah, now it's up to 12, by the way.
Okay. Yeah, we speak.
I mean, that's absolutely true. I mean, you're a big underdog for a reason. You have to play clean, almost perfect football. But then if they do that, they've got enough offense to give themselves a chance in a shootout. They're going to have
to. Which is what they want to make it.
Well, yeah. But that's what they have to do.
Yeah.
Because this is not going to be a 20-23 game. You know, this game is going to be played in the 40s. And in order for Oklahoma to score in the 40s, they have got to take care of the football.
Maybe take a page out of the Plumlee Ole Miss playbook and see Jalen Hurts just run around on this defense. I don't think LSU is going to let that happen, but no. We'll see.